What's up, everyone? Welcome back. I'm Blake McLain, and I'm a music producer. So today, I'm actually going to do, by request, 13 times Harry Styles' vocals have me shook. And I'm actually also doing it for another reason. So today is the very last day for this contest that I have going on. There's a link down in the description for it. It's in collaboration with Sugar 5 Design, which I'll put their logo up here as well. They did the logo for my new band and all that stuff. I mean, they're absolutely amazing. Honestly, absolutely amazing. But I have two Harry Styles tickets, amazing tickets for the Nashville show on the 29th. If you guys want them, again, the link is down in the description. Today's the very last day to enter. And you just follow the instructions down in the link and it'll tell you exactly what to do. So yeah, please enter that, help support. And also, my band just released our very first single yesterday. We're called Birds of Paradise and the song is called Till September. I hope to that down in the description, and I might try and put one up on the screen as well. Please go check it out. Please stream it. Let me know what you think. I think you guys will like it a lot, though. We put a lot of time and effort into it, so yeah. That being said, we're gonna jump right in, like, subscribe, all that good stuff, and let's go. 13 times Harry Styles' vocals have me shook. You guys know I love his vocals, so this is gonna be sweet. I'm excited.
When he opens his arms and holds you close tonight,
it's young Harry.
It just won't feel right, 'cause I can't love you more than this, yeah. When he lays you down, I might just die inside. It just don't feel right, 'cause I can't love you more than this. Can love you more than
God, you can just tell how young he was, just in his vocal. Even if I couldn't see him, you can just tell because of where his placement is, where everything kind of sits. I mean, it's definitely farther back. He doesn't have, like, as much control of his vocal, but it's just, it goes to show you can tell where there's pure, raw talent in somebody. What's next?
Brooklyn,
nice.
Empty avenues, there's no water inside this swing. That's enough from you. Oh, tell me something I don't already know.
Damn, dude.
Oh, tell me something I don't already know.
Here's to his band, too, because, oh my god, those are like Eagles harmonies. Like, those are just, those sit so well and they're so tight, too. Man. So notice this too, you know, I've been working on my vocals a bunch lately as well, and just kind of trying to increase my range and get to, you know, a different spot, and so I've learned a lot, and look at how relaxed he is with everything that he does. He really keeps, like, everything in the same sort of little spot, so he's not really, like, grabbing onto his consonants all that much. He's really just kind of letting those vowels take it.
I'm
seen some of these before, like this one. I did his documentary on the Patreon, and I've probably watched the thing like 2-3 times, because sometimes it's nice to watch other artists just in the way they work and stuff like that, because it gives you a different perspective, you know what I mean? Especially if you're stuck writing something, you know, or songwriting. It's just a lot of times you can kind of come at it a different way, and everybody does it differently, you know? But I love these live sessions from that documentary. You know, he uses like a different part of his vocal for this too. It's almost a lighter part of his vocal, especially on that whole first beginning. You know, that running through the garden, like up in there. You know, he obviously sits a little bit higher up in that, but you get what I'm saying. It's just a really nice, light, airy part of his vocal, which is amazing. But it also opens up the song to give him the opportunity to go full on if he wants. Notice that he sings out of the side of his mouth too, when I run out of rope. Like he always kind of does the little Elvis thing like that. Oh, you bring me got a little bit of that country twang to his voice. Honestly, if he wasn't, you know, I wonder if his accent actually just sort of muddies it a little bit. Somebody told me not that long ago that actually, like, the United States, like, southern accent is about the closest thing that you can get to a British accent. It makes sense, you know, the way that you kind of make the words. So it would also make sense that they sort of coincide a little bit. How would I tell her that she's all I think about?
Has run dry, and that's what's going on. Nothing's fine, I'm so wrong.
Man, that was a throwback. The story of my life, I seek her home. I drive all night to keep her warm inside. That is such a hard song to sing, too. I've tried that a billion times. It is a hard song to sing. And he just crushes it, man. Nobody can tear me down. There it is. Nobody can tear me down. 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 I love that down. It's just so sick. It's so bluesy too. I'd like to never know, tell me those stories. All right.
Not who I used to be. She floats through the room on a pink balloon. Some say she's such a fake that her love isn't bad. Oh, no. No, no, no.
Okay.
Just
there
like
it is. That's good.
Welcome to the final show.
You know, I've always thought too, his voice reminds me of a mix, especially like whenever he does Falling Live and Sign of the Times too. It sounds like a mix of like Bon Jovi and like oh my gosh. Who else? There's like David Bowie or something like that. You know, it's got, he maintains that full voice, that he has that full rich tone as he moves up into his higher register, which is a very difficult thing to do. A lot of people end up thinning it out as they go up, but he ends up just finding that one little spot and sort of just staying there. And a lot of it has to do with him just not moving, like not, you know, relaxing and actually just kind of letting it fly up into there. You know, he's not grabbing onto the consonants so much. He's staying on those vowels and just sticking in that little spot.
Hope you're wearing your best clothes.
That's why he doesn't move his mouth that much. Zayn, same thing. Have you ever watched his stuff? He doesn't move his mouth very much at all. It looks very, very, very relaxed, almost overly relaxed.
Can't bribe the door on your way to the sky. You look pretty good down here. You look really good. Just stop your crying. Now the time of your life. We're breaking through the atmosphere. Things are pretty good from here. Remember, everything will be alright. We can meet again somewhere far away from here.
He just kind of jumps right into that. I'm not gonna scream at the top of my lungs right now. So you guys are just getting falsetto today. That one gives me chills every single time. Like, that one, without a doubt, since the first time I've heard it, chills every single time. And I'm sure if this list was updated, Falling would be on there as well, because that one, especially that live performance, what was it, at the BBC Awards? Man. All right, everyone, well, thanks for hanging around. I really hope you enjoyed the video as much as I did. And again, thank you to Sugar 5 Design. If you guys want to submit for the contest, the link is down in the description. I'll put it down in the comments as well. And please go stream my new song till September, or my band's new song till September. And until next time, I will catch y'all later.